are a platinum sponsor here at Distree, a brand name that is a leader in the home networking space, and a company that's known for listening very closely to the voice of their customers. So here to share some of their perspective and insight with us, please join me in welcoming to the stage from Linksys, Aminullah Khan. Aman.
Good evening, everyone. And welcome to District 2016. We have seen some lovely videos from GFK, and I'm already feeling a little nervous about showing my videos. But then, let's start with one.
In an ideal world, everyone will have flawless connections to the internet. Fast, safe, flawless connections. Fast connections make us more fun. Safe connections make us more productive. Flawless connections make us more creative and help us grow. At Linksys, we work in relentless pursuit of that ideal world. Making better Wi-Fi every day. Because when your Wi-Fi is awesome, it makes life that much more awesome too.
Thank you. Now what you have just seen is a marketing video, but then it's really backed up with some research data. What you see here is the result of a recently conducted research in partnership with IDC. Consumers voted Wi-Fi as the number two item which they do not want to live without. Honestly, when I looked at the research data, I was wondering what's happening to our society. Why? Because I would have expected some of the items on this chart to be more important than Wi-Fi. But then, hey, we are not complaining, right? We are here to provide awesome Wi-Fi to our consumers, and that is what they want. Part of the problem is while we as consumers are spending thousands of dollars buying these smart devices, smartphones, tablets, smart screens, and now home automation equipment, smart appliances. But what we are not doing is not investing in getting this latest Wi-Fi technology, which is creating the whole bottleneck and creating this performance issues for all the devices that we are investing. The other part of the problem is definitely not a problem, but what we see is there are a lot of devices coming online. Now, I want to take my family as an example. Okay, a couple of years back, probably I had three devices connected to the network. And what was I doing with these devices? I was probably browsing the internet, checking my emails, and probably doing a bit of online shopping, right? Today, I have more than 20 devices which are connected to my home network. Today, I've got more than 5 to 6 devices which are simultaneously trying to connect to my router. And my usage has moved from simply an email and online browsing to online streaming of high definition video, online gaming, online music streaming. Sonos has become one of the popular music systems. So what we are doing today is we are doing a lot of high bandwidth activity. And that is, your technology needs to keep up with this transition that is happening in your home to be able to support the demand on your Wi-Fi. So we at Linksys, we work on bringing in the latest in the technology to be able to support our consumers. I want to again share a short video here, please.
The more users and devices you have on your Wi-Fi network, the more your network seems to slow down. That's because older routers can only serve one device at a time, causing lag and buffering issues during heavy bandwidth activities like gaming or streaming. Linksys multiple user MIMO routers serve multiple devices simultaneously, maximizing the router's full capacity, resulting in a more responsive Wi-Fi connection with faster speeds for everyone on your busy home network.
Now let me put some perspective to the video that you have watched, right? Let me try and explain the best way I can here. So this is your conventional router. Your conventional router, which is not a non-MU MIMO router, is capable of speaking to one device at a time. But you have already seen in my previous slide, there are multiple devices in your home which are trying to connect to your router, trying to speak to your router. So what's happening is when the router is speaking to one of your devices, there are four other devices which are in the queue trying to speak to your router. And that's slowing down the entire performance of your home network. Now what we bring and what we have launched for the first time, industry's first MU MIMO router last year, was the E8500. And what does that do? The MU MIMO technology, a router with an MU MIMO technology, is capable of communicating with multiple devices at the same time. Now just imagine what does that do to your network. Now suddenly, the four devices which were in the queue to talk to your router have got a router which is able to speak to them at the same time. That's like having an independent, dedicated router to each of your devices. And that's why you immediately see a great performance improvement in your home network. Today, we are taking this experience to the next level. At this week, globally, for the first time, we are giving you a sneak peek into what is coming in the future, in the very near future, that is launching in January. The world's first tri-band MU MIMO router, which is capable of streaming 4K video on as many devices. Up to, you can come have a look at our presentation on a board. There are 20 devices connected to this, streaming 4K video simultaneously. We are also giving you a sneak peek into the world's first MU MIMO range extender and also the world's first MU MIMO USB adapter to bring your non-MU MIMO devices to the MU MIMO technology. So here is a family of Maxstream MU MIMO routers, range extenders and the USB adapter. All of it for you to have a look, see the demo, feel it, and experience it. Now, I'm sure you have heard about cloud router. Now, when I hear about cloud router, I generally ask my partners, have you ever seen that cloud? And I haven't had answers from any of my partners saying, yeah, we have seen the cloud. We have started the journey of this creating a smart Wi-Fi platform for our Linksys routers way back in 2008 When Cisco invested $120 million to acquire Pure Networks, we laid the foundation for the consumer cloud platform in 2008. We have built the smart Wi-Fi ground up. We have evolved it, and as we speak, we are launching the version 2 of the smart Wi-Fi platform. I'm very proud to say Ethernet Smart Wi-Fi is the most advanced consumer cloud networking platform. So, what is changing on Ethernet Smart Wi-Fi? I'm going to give you a few examples, right? The first one, what is it today? What you're able to do today is you're able to remotely and locally manage your network. You're able to provide guest access. Give you an example why you need to provide guest access. The first thing that the guests do when they walk into your home is, can I have your password? And I'm very happy to give the password to my guests. I trust them, but I don't trust what happens when they go out of my network. I don't know what happens when they're out there in the field. So we're able to create a private guest network, which is independent of your network. Okay, and then it doesn't, so we're able to give them passwords so they can browse and create a virtual private network. What is changing with the latest smart Wi-Fi 2.0 is we are starting to give you, first of all, the whole look and feel is changing. Two, we are now starting to give you some basic notifications. Whether the router is offline or the router is online, we are able to give you some basic notifications. And come October, we will make this reactive smart Wi-Fi to a completely active platform. Now, what does this active platform mean? When you buy a router and then install it, your router is working on a particular channel. Every router is working on share. When I say 2 minutes, I need to rush. I'll do that. So all the routers are connected to a certain channel. When all the routers are connected to a certain channel, there is a lot of interference and that slows down the network. So Linux Smart Wi-Fi is able to actively survey, look at what channels are free and able to give you a notification saying, do you want to switch your, there is a free channel, the current channel is clogged, or it's too crowded, or it is hampering the performance of the network, do you want to change to a free channel which is available? You say yes, or you change to the new channel. Now for our retailers, I'll give you a very good example, right? So in a home network, your network performs to the lowest performing device. So just as an example, I have an old laptop. I've given it to my daughter so that she can use it. I haven't bought a new laptop for her. So that's a G laptop. So what it does is it slows down the entire network to work on a G speed, wireless G speed. Now, your smart Wi-Fi can go to the extent of identifying that there is a wireless G device in your network that is slowing down the complete network, do you want to replace it? Okay, do you want to bring it out so the network can perform to the optimum level? Now we can go a step further. We can say Carrefour, Sharab DT, Emacs, Jerry, they are running a promo on the latest AC technology notebook. Would you like to buy them? And then we can take the consumer right onto their online website, and they're able to order it, and they're able to get it delivered. So we can take this to the next level. This is great. Now what's going to happen in the home networking space in the future? I'm not talking about too long future, I'm talking about the next 2, 3, 4 months. There's something which is coming, which is whole home Wi-Fi. Now, what is whole home Wi-Fi? Whole home Wi-Fi, which is also called Wi-Fi in a box, It comes with multiple all-in-one devices that serves as a router, as a range extender, as an access point, as a power line kit. Okay, today, whole home Wi-Fi is in fraction of the entire networking market. But by 2017, that's going to grow to a $100 million subcategory. I want you to start thinking about this. Okay, this is a great opportunity for us to bring in new consumers on board. Whole home Wi-Fi is going to be seamless. It's going to offer seamless connectivity across all your devices. It is going to offer app-based setup. So the whole fear of getting your network set up is going to be thrown out of the window. So this is something which is coming. It is going to be a completely new category, a new subcategory within the home networking space. Okay, this is something we want to really engage with you and bring this opportunity to the market. Watch the space. We believe by October we should be making some great announcements here. With that, I want to say thank you. And thank you very much.
Adnan, thank you very much. You heard it here first from Linksys. When you rank basic human needs, food still ranks number one, but Wi-Fi is really number two. It says something about our modern life. I'm not surprised by that result, in fact.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Aman.